That's no moon. It's a space station.
What's going on, Star Wars fam? The vigilante destroys white supremacy, and Black Chrysanthemum beats the crap out of a bunch of Trandoshans. All of that and more on Shootin' the Poodoo.
Air drums.
That episode of Peacemaker is probably my favorite. So far, it's been my favorite. How's everybody doing tonight, Raven? Sorry about last night. I was with you. What the hell are you talking about?
What happened to Raven?
Oh, what did you do to her, Dan?
See, dude, you can't.
I didn't do anything.
Pop off like that, bro.
I'm just saying, the Packers.
Raven, she only contacted.
It was the Packers last night, man. Blocked punt, ruined the whole game.
Oh no, not sports.
I know. I'm sorry. Look,
everybody's well-being is good.
But look at this, Jackson. What size stay on target do you take?
Large.
That's right, baby. So, how's everybody doing? How's your week? How was your weekend?
Hello, pretty Dan.
Good. Everybody pretty in the good. Chat. How's everyone doing?
It's good. You know what? I'm jealous. I'm jealous of Brooke.
Play some games.
Why? He's got some. He's got some New England IPA.
Oh, is that what that is?
Yeah, it's workhorse, baby.
Yeah. On the other hand, I'm drinking some Elysian space dust.
Oh, hell yeah. Space dust is my shit.
Space dust.
Exactly, man. We got to drink. We got to get beer, dude.
Oh, there you go.
Huh? We're getting beers. We're going to get beers, Rook.
Yeah. Yeah.
We're going to hurt ourselves.
When we do the retreat, it's going to be great.
It's going to be a lot of ibuprofen and Pepsi.
I know. Me and Chris have done it. I've been up your way when Rise of Skywalker came out. I just saw you. Yeah, after work.
Forgot how big Dan's hands are in real life.
Really? You got big hands, Dan?
He has massive hands.
Can I ask you a personal question? Links. What size glove do you take?
Very good.
Matter of fact, I wear like a medium large glove, but it's just because my fingers are short yet fat.
Yeah, they're wide.
Look at Raven.
Width is Dan's problem. It's the width.
Are you a shower or a grower?
Lots of girth on these palms. Mad girth on these palms. Hey, Chris, are you smoking?
Hey. We don't talk about girth Brooks like that.
Oh, God.
Woo!
Dan rides a children's cycle. Dan rides a children's cycle.
Starting off great tonight, boys.
I've had three sips.
You guys are awful.
Wow, just right downhill at the start.
We talk about nerd stuff too.
Yeah, we're here for nerd stuff. Yeah, sorry.
Need that shirt, Jackson. Like, cough it over, dude.
What's that?
That shirt's amazing.
Oh, you like this one? Right?
I love that. That is a really nice shirt. Yeah,
dude.
Thank you.
Every time I think of John Carpenter, I think of James Woods and the one.
John Carpenter's Vampires?
Yeah, John Carpenter's Vampires.
John Carpenter's Vampires when you think of John Carpenter.
Wait, is that one of my favorite movies?
Whoa. I love that movie.
John Carpenter Vampires.
Yes, Mike, you got a little something right there. You go.
I know
buddy.
What I got.
I got some chip.
It's a chip.
I had chips earlier.
I would want someone to do that to me too, buddy.
You know, okay, Dan, John wise. Carpenter's Vampires.
Yes.
That's your go-to John That's Carpenter?
It's one of my favorite
movies. Wait, Roke, what about yours?
The Thing?
Okay. I love The Thing.
Okay. Raven?
Okay, I have a second too, sorry.
I don't have an opinion.
Raven loves Big Trouble Little China. There.
Okay, that's good. I'll take that. Mine is Prince of Darkness.
Great movie. Way better than John Carpenter's Vampires.
But it's my opinion, and I'm allowed to have it.
Oh,
can I ask
that
Chris?
Movie with
Chris?
What, Daniel Baldwin? That's the one you want?
Daniel Baldwin is like a carbon copy
in his wide coke head. He looks like Richard Sadar.
I want to know what Chris's John Carpenter movie is. I want to know what Chris's John Carpenter is.
I know what Chris's favorite John Carpenter movie is the thing. I did it for you, buddy.
Yeah?
Probably. He loves that movie.
I just love James Woods as an actor. He's makes me laugh all the time.
I love James Woods. Do it, Dan. Go ahead.
I love James Woods.
Too bad he's insane.
He's a human being, he's right. But as an actor, he's phenomenal to watch.
That's why I said amazing. As an actor, yes.
As an actor. As an actor.
Too bad he's donuts.
Agreed. Yeah.
As an actor.
He's a specialist donuts.
As someone who owns the specialist, let me just assure you that James Woods,
again,
as an actor,
specialist,
is phenomenal to watch.
I heard when he has dance-sized hands, too, by the way.
Like this. The Specialist and Assassins. That's the movie we watch.
You guys hear that, Dan?
Fly later on.
That's right, baby.
I heard James Woods has dance-sized hands, too. Dan,
that'd be pretty interesting.
Yeah,
they're so wide, dude. They're like donut sticks.
That's what I heard.
You're an appetizer at Baskin Robbins.
Legendary, if you know what I mean.
Dude, he's an electrician.
Penis.
Yeah.
Oh, man. No one knows what you mean.
This is off to a great start. Oh, there he is.
So hey,
Uh-oh.
We should probably talk about Peacemaker.
The stuff? Yeah.
Yeah, let's talk about episode of
good episode. Peacemaker. Serious episode. Liked it.
Okay, can we?
Yes.
All right, so maybe not everybody, and we've done this in the last couple of episodes. Maybe not everybody has seen the most recent episode of Peacemaker. So I took the liberty of making an overlay.
Oh boy.
Wait. Whoa.
Face exercises.
So they can't identify me in a lineup. That was like the best. Wait, I could just beat him.
A duck can't beat in a human suit.
The vigilante here. I messed up.
Oh, Blaze Cap, come back.
Oh my god.
Okay.
It's all right. So
I
anyway,
as, a gym.
As vigilante, I would like to say that I was the star of this episode.
Right.
And it was really good to see him proven as an actual badass. That's what made me happy. Mm-hmm. It's like I wasn't sure. I was like, when he was just like whistling, "It's a Small World After All," as he was like, I think that's what it was, as he was shooting the butterflies, like the kids and the family.
I mean, they made him like, Deadpool light. Right.
Yeah, fine. Exactly. He is Deadpool light.
It's fine. Vigilante is awesome. Regardless.
But he was so great, as in like he doesn't flinch with any of that stuff. There's definitely a screw loose.
To the trash can scene.
Oh my god! I don't think that would have instantly landed him in jail, but I don't care.
But just the way he chose to get arrested.
At first, I was like, "Is he trying to break in front of all these cops?"
I was like, what are you? And then, oh my god! I'm like, "Yeah, your pinky toe." That's why it took him extra long.
Yeah.
Like, oh, he's also like, British, because of course he is.
And then he's like,
"Is he really?"
Oh yeah, he was on Thrones.
And then was he really on Thrones?
Yeah, he was like some background guy. Oh. He's the guy that gets killed in an episode.
Oh, okay. Well,
he was on Thrones. Yeah, like, he looked sadder, obviously, because there's no sun.
Yeah.
Unless you're on a certain part of the world.
Yeah. So, I just, like, I feel like...
No sun, Jackson.
When he was getting arrested, he was like, "Please watch my injury. I have a
he was like, "My right toe is like, I don't... You know, you can still... you can still walk without it, but I'm just saying, like, just be careful."
I love the moment that they were having in the car as they were driving, and like Peacemaker apologizes to him and everything, and they had that moment. And he's like, "Nah, man." He's like, "Nah, I was overboard with the toe thing, dude." You know, like,
and that's again the greatness of James Gunn, how he gives it, he brings it back. Like everything comes back, everything comes back. Even the serious stuff. There's a lot of serious stuff I think people may have overlooked because it wasn't a joke. That's going to come back.
And we're talking about the family stuff, you mean, or
not even the family stuff. That's whatever. I'm talking about stuff like again, another thing, we're going to touch on that. Peacemaker has been keeping things from people and using them as, like, toys. And then he goes, okay, now I'll tell them what's going on because things moved. Like, he had the spaceship thing for, like, two episodes. Didn't tell anybody. He just had it. He's, like, playing with it like it's like a rocket ship.
Right.
Then it becomes a rocket ship. And now he has the legit butterfly in a jar.
Yeah.
You're like, you have getting a butterfly. You have a captured butterfly.
He's getting it high.
That part and right there.
High. So, yeah. And I want to jump to the end real quick. I know, but the stinger with the whole. Can we... Yeah, what's up, Raven? I'm sorry.
Can we get the creepy tongue guy out of my box, please? It's creeping me out.
Out of my box. Get it out of my section.
So
no, I meant out of my box. I am here for humor.
Yeah. I definitely loved how we're yep.
Every Sunday, 9 p.m. Eastern.
Yes, you will find this happening. I love when Leota was like finally was breaking down what Peacemaker's all about, how she notices that because of his environment, how he was raised, there might be some fucked up things about him, but that's not like really who he is and like how his heart is. Like he's actually a good person. Like he's not a racist, you know, white supremacist like his father. But you know, being raised by that, you're gonna definitely see the world through a different lens.
Yeah. Dude, the white dragon outfit is like
that, what spot the on. Fuck is that?
The helmet is spot.
I have never seen him. So I've never known Peacemaker until Suicide Squad. Mm-hmm. And you know, Raven, he's back in your box.
Up. There it is.
There it is.
All is well.
But
box free.
But that's the best thing about this show is that we're getting that character development of Peacemaker, and that even though he says the wrong things a lot, it may seem like he's
getting
like,
better.
Yeah, but like you can tell that he's actually a good guy. He's not a bad dude, right. And like a lot of his ideals were really beaten into him by his abusive father. And it's also
woke by the end of the season.
And it's also a place to like generational trauma too, where like you know, I wonder how the White Dragon's dad was to him to get him this way.
Yeah. Probably worse.
That's you know what I mean. And like you know, Peacemaker almost made it out alive, especially like being abused by you know, I didn't feel nothing when you were born, and you know, your brother was way better than you, and all this other tough shit that he said to him. I was like, man.
Did you see what happens to his brother? You're just like.
Holy crap, where's the therapy? He's gonna need all kinds of therapy.
That's why he's, you know, doing what he's doing.
I can't actually wait to watch this with Julie because she's gonna love this part. Like she's gonna love all of that because of her job.
And I actually like the fact that they, you know, Vigilante was interesting, and obviously he kind of threaded himself into the team, really, like he basically forced himself, but actually he's shown his usefulness, but he's also shown like a very strange, albeit warped morality that is kind of, it's definitely different than your average cape television show or movie. You know, it's like, He definitely has he doesn't like racists, he doesn't like bigots, he doesn't like people picking on his friends. He wants to have a friend, but he also, you know, doesn't have any problem pulling the trigger on, you know,
he may take things up just a bit too far.
He might take things a little bit serious. So I enjoy that kind of that exploration of that character, and this is a good episode, and I feel like there's going to be more opening up between him and Harcourt in the next one. Yeah, we need a psychopath. Yeah. We all need a psychopath, man.
He's perfect for
these guys, like, are stuck with me.
The role that he plays is absolutely perfect. And I just loved it because I was like, oh my God, he's in jail and he sits down with like the White Dragon and all of his freaking, you know,
cronies,
his clan.
Fodder.
Well, they're a clan. And you know. And like he goes in there, he's like, "Let's get to know each other."
You've been practicing. You've been practicing this since the episode came out. Do it, Dan.
What?
The line. Do the line.
I don't know the line. I didn't practice anything, Jackson. Oh, you put me on the spot. Jesus.
I was like,
I wish I could say the crap that he was saying, like, and remembered every word of it.
I would like to be I'm thankful that black people brought us rock and roll.
Yes. Yes. Oh my God. And he was just like, all that hillbilly shit that you guys enjoyed 38 special. Wouldn't even exist. That's beautiful. Oh my God. Like, and like, I at first, like, I thought he was just gonna start being like,
I'm thankful for traffic lights.
He just like, he escalated. Like, he literally just was like, here, and then boom, and just started talking so much shit. And then when we finally actually got to see his hand to hand combat skills, I was like, he's ridiculous. I love this dude. He can talk the talk and he fucking walks the walk, dude. Like, this
better
guy,
walks.
I mean, like, where was his training?
That's what I was wondering, Dan. Like, obviously, we know that Peacemaker was trained by his father,
right?
What's the matter, Raven? You can't take this seriously. You can't can't take this right here seriously.
Yeah. Do you want to taste it? Raven.
Raven's got her helmet on.
Yay, Raven! Oh, there you go. Activate Sonic Boom.
Oh my God, Katrina! Liquid. No way.
Wait, what happened?
Look.
Oh, no. I'm sorry.
That's kind of funny.
I've been there.
Vigilante is a marriage too. I love it.
Fantastic. Love it. Fantastic.
Quite possibly.
No, but he's a good, like, it's funny because me and Chris are familiar with the CW stuff. In the CW show, he was super serious. So, like, seeing him, like, he was on Arrow.
He's on Arrow. How about the costume? Was it similar?
Similar, yeah. But in that world, and only in that world, he has a healing factor, so he can't even die. Because he gets, like, his whole thing is, I think one of the seasons, like, a metaverse bomb went off, and it made a bunch of people in the city like metahumans. Raven's having a hard time.
Kind of like the Terrigen Mist, like static shock.
Yeah, and it's pretty cool actually. So Black Canary is like, they're like tied up, and he's about to get his brains blown out. And as the wave is hitting them, she's screaming for her life. So that's when she gets the voice. And as it goes past him, he gets shot in the head, which makes him invulnerable to death. And then he comes back, and
so it's a love story.
Ah,
the Arrow stuff. Yeah, like, yeah. Him and Canary were like, they were partners. They were cops. Stuff. But this one is not very serious though.
This is like the only thing I've liked DC since like Smallville. I'm sorry.
But, you trying to get on Chris's good side.
Peacemaker is like a show?
Sucking up.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
Is that all you see? Have you watched any other ones? Or
Turgeon Mist.
I've watched Smallville, but not. Smallville, but not
Turgeon Mist.
I highly recommend Young Justice. That's all I gotta say.
Okay,
there's four seasons now. Take your time. Take your time, Jackson.
Kiss
I'm
him, Roke.
I'm not gonna rush you.
Kiss him, Roke. Not eat his brain.
But I was hungry. But yeah. Take your time. Watch it. It's great.
Okay. I will.
But yes.
If you recommend it, I'm going to watch it.
This show is very good. Oh, thanks. Easy by John Carpenter.
Wow. Okay.
So the one thing that I also noticed about this was that Judo Master, who I'm so glad that he's not dead.
Sure. Yeah, he's great.
Do you think that
he's the Judo Master, Dan.
Do you think Leota shot him because he was about to spill the beans about what butterflies are? You think that was purposely done?
I don't know.
Did she just like saw an opportunity and did it? Or like, it seems like the theme so far has been keep Peacemaker from actually knowing what the butterflies are. And Judo Master was about to spill the beans and then boom, led right to the chest.
I think personally that Leota is in on this in some capacity.
Well, yeah, I mean, she's Waller's daughter.
So she definitely tried to stop him from knowing. Yeah, exactly. And I don't buy that she didn't kill anybody before.
She's probably the shit in real life. She's probably like some sleeper agent or like
yeah. Yeah, there's something up with that. Like,
she's
right?
killing everybody.
Yeah. She's gonna have a scene where she does like gun gymnastics or something ridiculous. Like, you know.
Yeah. All right.
And also, John Economist has asthma. Represent respect to all you asthma sufferers out there.
Taser face has asthma. You heard it, Cole. Yep.
Asthma.
It's hilarious. Actually.
Make sure you always carry your inhaler.
Always. You know, it's funny. I actually have an inhaler in my car, a spare one for my brother in case I'm around my brother and he needs one.
Good.
It's in my car.
There you go.
You shouldn't leave it in the car when it's too cold, Dan.
His hands are also wide.
Well, I mean, that's his fault.
Wide fingers on Dan.
Bro, we are trying so hard to stay between the lines and you just keep veering off. You know,
I can't go between the lines with Dan's hands in the way.
Oh, you know what, guys? My connection's starting to break down.
You're using up too much bandwidth with your name. Scrolling.
Dan, were you amazing at making snowballs as a kid? Or were you just like, I got this. Just give me all the
snowballs. I had no problem with Thumb Wars.
No kidding.
Broke. He started making snowballs and it ended up being snowmen. It was you couldn't make them small enough.
He's giving them clothes. It was crazy.
Stop talking about snow. It's snowing here again.
Ugh. Oh, I'm sorry.
Hey, Snowball, wear the scarf. You're a snowman now.
Hello there.
Hello. Oh, it is Lord. I, Tommy.
What's up, bro?
Thomas on a
hit
right
in
now.
Here, man.
Once he's on break.
Okay, he's driving. He'll
be here on break. He's driving.
Call him. We're not going to tell anybody.
Whoa. We can't have the EHS manager here in this shit.
No, that's
right.
Yeah, that's right.
We're driving. No.
Right. Hey, Red Tornado, thank you for being there the other night when I was testing out the game streaming on the YouTube. It was good. He was good.
Yeah, I saw Ray. Me and Ray were talking to each other.
That was on Twitch. Sure. That was on Twitch when I was doing it. I actually tried from the Broaxium YouTube, and Chris was like, what is this?
Murder sounds.
And I was like, I'm just trying something out. I'll delete it as soon as I'm done. And I did.
It's good to keep him on his toes.
Sometimes you need to just, you know, go right into the deep end and try some things out. And there's some that's how I felt when I got the text. But there's some
kinks to work out at this moment.
There's definitely some kinks to work out, but I think that might be something that's going to happen in the future with some Star Wars gaming. So
yeah. I'm down with that.
We'll see.
I'm there too.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll get it.
Hey, bro,
get it going.
Rick's in there. Rick's in there.
I'm in there.
Hey.
Speaking of Star Wars.
It's fine until I look at you.
What an excellent segue.
You know, it's fundamental basketball over here. You got to just move it down the court.
Yep.
It's all about the basket, you know?
Thumbs out, man. Thumbs out.
Thumbs out, dude. Bend your legs. Bend them with the free throw.
Gonna push those balls. Bend them. Push those balls. Push those.
All right, Cloudy Skies.
Jesus. Anyways.
Stay puff over here.
Book of Boba Fett, chapter 4, The Gathering Storm.
The Gathering Storm.
It was, in fact, good.
Don't touch my buttons.
Now I assume, as we always assume, that all of you people watching in the chat have already seen the Book of Boba Fett, but I took the liberty of making an overlay for those who haven't. So in order to prevent you from seeing any spoilers.
Oh boy. Oh jeez.
Yep.
When I see the boxes switching around, I get nervous.
Yeah, we're entering the Book of Boba Fett nervous. Spoiler zone.
Yes!
Black Santa, what's up, homie?
Yeah. Before we get to that, though,
Wookiee's
in the house.
Oh, my God. Listen, I know that part really was meant for me. Jon Favreau and Dave Filoni have been watching this. And they realized, like, this hashtag Dan hates trained oceans going around. Let's
give him a bone.
Let's do a scene that's going to make him happy. Because you know what? Deep down inside, nobody likes trained oceans. And I know you guys are all liars. So it was great. It was great, that scene.
We can't
start off there. I was happy to see that this was a very Fennec heavy episode.
Yes.
Finally.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Migna got her moment in the sun of this.
Yes.
And then her son was in this scene. Her baby boy is in this scene right here.
What?
Yeah.
He's also Thundercat.
Yeah.
Thundercat.
Can we talk about Thundercat?
He's in the background. You'll see. You'll see.
Just Thundercat killing it.
It was really cool that he was involved. And that we got to finally see the everything happened to her. That moment in Mandalorian where that terrible character was involved, Toro. Fuck Toro. It was all tied to that episode. And it's pretty cool how we've gotten to see like the flashbacks building up from Boba Fett coming out of the Sarlacc through the Mandalorian. Up until now, it's been pretty awesome. And it, like, how about this tattoo cyber bar? Like,
dude,
yeah,
Thundercat.
You know, it's this parlor, like, that's well, like basically.
Up, I was like, yo,
the cybernetic enhancement version of a tattoo parlor. Like, in the
it was crazy.
It so
was nuts because when they pulled out, I was like, what's this funky bass? This
I want to like go Thundercat. In there and I want to go in there and ask for directions.
Hey man, that guy needs soup.
Right.
Also,
right.
Which
you guys validate parking?
Yeah.
I
just live here in the basement.
I enjoyed the part. Like any like.
Can I get a bottle of milk? No. Just not chocolate milk. Just regular.
Do you have a cup of sugar, milk. Sir? You have whole a cup milk. Of sugar.
That's all I want. I just want a whole milk.
This is a whole milk, please.
Hello, whole milk.
Whole milk, please. Thank you.
Oh, what were you saying, Dan?
What
Sorry.
Are you guys talking about?
As Boob said, yes. Right, I was told that was Ming-Na's son. I didn't know this until I think it was one of the people that I watched in the Sloppy Seconds group watch. I'm not trying to take that credit, Boob. I'm just saying.
Who approved that it name, was by cool. the way, the Sloppy Seconds rewatch?
I don't know, but I love it. That's good.
I mean, I like it too. It's just, you know.
Those words together are just like,
exactly.
It's what a time.
But it was an amazing scene because I loved like just like all artists when they're doing like a tattoo or something, they don't want the work to be covered up. And Boba Fett was like, oh, what are we gonna do about covering it up? And he's like, and ruin all of this cybernetic glory?
Mm-hmm.
Hell no. Hell no.
You rock that. These are new pipe guts.
Yeah.
Where the well.
And one of the things that one of the incidents that happened was that basically Boba released her from her debt.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like you do this job for me, help me out, and your debt's paid, and she stuck around. Now that does open up, as I said, I was on Alex and Molly's show, Star Wars Explained, the
killed it, bro.
Book report. Oh, thanks, man. And I did say that, you know, this does open up, this paves the way for Faboshefek, which is my name for the relationship between Boba Fett and Fennec Shand. Faboshefek. Hashtag Faboshefek. I'm not a Bonek. I'm a Faboshefek. And I think...
so hard to say.
Where's the chef we're coming from?
The
chef.
Hey, bro.
Just say it. Faboshefek.
Faboshefek.
You can do it if not that hard.
Where's the shah coming from?
Shand?
Okay.
Dan.
Okay.
How insensitive.
She's right behind.
No, Jackson, that is unacceptable. Faboshefek. I will not support that.
Well, you have to support Faboshefek. Support.
No, I don't.
Anyway, the fish.
I do not have to support that. I do not support that.
No.
I will.
You spelt it wrong, Boop, but I love you anyways.
Don't encourage him when I'm trying to rein him in. Don't encourage him.
Just wait a minute now. Wait a minute. So anyways, I think it's possible that they have a relationship. But again, I did say, I know I'm a bridge. I did say also that I think that there's a possibility that we might see Fennec double cross Boba. I don't know.
People are saying it. Everyone's saying it. I have had that feeling.
I don't know.
It would just be seriously fucked up.
Stanton, you crazy.
I'm sorry. It'd be so fucked up because he even told her during this scene that he would dedicate himself to protecting her and to having her back. And like anybody that would turn against somebody that has dedicated themselves to help keeping them safe and giving them the respect and everything. You know what? Fuck Fennec at that point. Fuck her.
Yeah.
If that's the way she's gonna go.
But that's what baddies do. That's what baddies do. Don't forget. I mean, Anakin.
How is she a baddie? Just because she's an assassin.
Yeah.
It takes all kinds.
I mean, Anakin. Basically, thumbed his nose at Obi-Wan, who had taken care of him for such a long. Wait, is Black Chrysanthemum saying something different?
He just wants to hurt people. He just, don't mind him.
Okay.
He just like, what could I hurt?
He's
I was
very
like,
angry.
Later.
He just wants to chew up as a baby and
yeah, there's definitely some abandonment issues that Santi is dealing with.
I definitely believe
that Santi was captured by Trandoshans. That's how he became a gladiator. I think he was captured by Trandoshans and he was bought off. And that's where he got into the gladiator scene, maybe. I don't know the full story of Santi, but that sounds like why he hates them so much.
It was him.
You were adding a narrative to fit your hatred for Trandoshans, but by giving Black K this backstory that it's a Trandoshan-induced hatred?
We know that Trandoshans...
Just
spoil Life Day. They just jump in on Life Day and capture Wookiees on their day of celebration and sell them to slavery.
And
all of them?
They are a hunting race and they do this to Wookiees.
And Chris,
they deserve
also
a Death Star cleansing. A Death Star cleansing. The planet Trandosha.
Wow.
Dan hates Trandosha.
Dan hates Trandosha.
He also
hell yeah,
he's just splitting the plot to Gladiator.
It's no, like, I won't so stand for
that
it.
That can't happen because that's already a movie called Gladiator.
I was on
Santi's side during the bar scene,
it was Black
and I was
Santin,
like, I was
Russell Crowe.
I was waiting for it, baby. I saw him. He's just slamming back them drinks.
It was me, Maximus. It was great.
Hey, you know what? You know what? He at least compromised. He was gonna rip both arms off. He was gonna rip both. He had him by both shoulders to go.
Joaquin Phoenix was there,
and Garza Fwip. She was like, she's like, chill. We'll pay your tab, and he's like, man, I am my own dude.
Put this arms in my head.
He listened to everything that Garza Fwip was saying. He was just like, I was gonna do it anyway.
He's like, I can pay my own tap.
Yeah, for real.
No. Sorry. Yeah, the last time you sell me into slavery.
Dog. He was like, I can't hear you over this arm.
We know that. I'm calling it right now. That's the backstory. That's why he hates them.
And do you hate them too, Dan?
Yes!
Dan hates Trandoshans.
Dan drinking that scotch like he's wearing a smoker's jacket. And another thing.
I don't think we should support Dan's hatred. I don't think we should support his hatred.
It was the cap was on.
Like, it ain't real, baby.
You know what, Raven? Listen, Raven. It's the only fictional creatures that I can't stand.
He can't dan them.
That doesn't work for me.
He dan stand them.
He can't. He dance. Dan
even Boba Fett was like,
"God
damn it, Jackson."
Even Boba Fett was just like, even when they're trying to be nice, they seem like they're up to something.
Oh,
Yeah.
Black Chris and Dan.
I like it. I like it.
Chris and Dan.
Chris and Dan.
That's going to be, I am changing that on my Twitter right now.
The artwork happen. You're listening? Black Chris and Dan.
Black Chris and Dan.
Oh, that's beautiful. That's beautiful. Let's go to edit.
I'm sorry I made that up, Chris. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Yep. Yep, that's all. He's gone.
The wide hands. Harry and the Hendersons.
Oh, man. That's beautiful. Done.
DJ Wicked.
Done. Black Boom.
Tommy's in the house.
Look, I've been a fan of Black Chrysanthemum since 2015 when he came into Darth Vader issue number one.
I've been a fan since I saw him being all muscly in this first episode. He was like, muscle Wookiee.
And ever since the Dan Hates Trandoshans campaign began, I was like, someone else out there has to hate them as much as I do. Black Chrysanthemum, everybody.
Well, yeah.
Boop.
Me and introduce you.
Oh, no.
What did Black Chrysanthemum? Piss Baby 420. It's actually Piss Baby 420 Blaze It Up. Thanks.
Well, since Tommy came to visit us on the break, why don't we hear some thoughts from Tommy on the
episode.
My mind is a blank slate. No, I'm kidding.
I don't believe that.
Way to drop the pass, jackass.
Oh, shit.
Oh.
Like the Packers.
We're going now. This last episode was it was awesome. We are not like most fans where we try to find shit to nitpick about. We enjoy it for what it is, and then we move on. Like that's how you're supposed to be a fan anyway. I enjoyed it very much. I think what I liked the most about it was we got to see kind of like the last remnants of Boba's savage side. So once he got the fire spray gunship, he went straight for the K-Riders? I can't remember what they're called. And he took them out, like, no hesitation, no mercy.
He enjoyed it.
That's you could just see like that's kind of like a light burn, like a flame burning out. That was the last of his savage side. Now he's ready to do better, and that's character progression right there.
Fennec also helped him with his revenge on the Sarlacc with the sonic boom.
Oh yeah, inadvertently. I don't think he's there to for the revenge side of the Sarlacc pill. He just wanted to get his armor, but
yeah.
You got revenge. Yeah, that was like the icing on the cake.
Yeah.
Do you think we've seen his savage side for the last time? Do you really think that?
Oh, probably not. I mean, we'll probably see it. It depends on what triggers it. It's obviously he's got a soft side for the Tuskens, so I could still see it being connected to that. So maybe in the next episode he finds out this next big battle. I don't think it's the Pikes. I think it's the Crimson Dawn. He's going to find out they killed the Tuskens, and he's going to go haywire.
Ooh, we got a Crimson Dawn prediction.
Yeah, that's
part of the character being a little bit older and being a little bit more experienced. That's kind of a process that you go through as you just go through life and you experience things. You are a little bit less likely to touch that savage side because you know what the results could be. In a way that you don't necessarily appreciate when it hasn't bit you in the ass yet, if you know what I mean. And I think that with Boba and both characters, both of our basically front facing characters here are people who are older. They've experienced stuff. So when they seem to just know things, it makes sense. It's like, well, yeah, because you've been in this situation or you've seen this kind of situation, 40, 50 times, unlike other characters that we've seen and, who are a little bit, wet behind the ears about things and a little less, that way, if that makes sense.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that does make
sense. So I don't think you've seen the last of it. I think it's really a situation where he's purposefully just not going there because it's part of the process of growing older.
Mm-hmm. So you're saying when I grow older, I will lose my rage if possibly if that happens.
It's possible.
Yes.
It's possible.
Oh,
I'm not saying it's a guarantee. I don't make generalizations like Dan does. I don't make generalizations about entire groups the way Dan does. So it's possible.
Oh shit. Oh shit. Oh shit. Sorry,
by the way, I think Boop tried to say sexiest on this one.
It's the sexiest.
Hey,
let's all laugh at Boop.
Lay off.
Oh, Din, you're never going to get on our good side. Don't even try.
I always will try.
Yeah, back off, donut fingers.
He's got crawlers on his hands.
Eclair hands over here.
Oh, no.
Looking like Stay Puff.
Stay Puff. Oh, I haven't heard that one. It's so accurate.
I shook his hand. I was like, Jesus Christ. You are an electrician. Holy shit. You've been doing this all your entire life.
It was like a freaking pack of ballpark Franks.
Fucking fret fingers over here. Banana hands over here. Jesus. What's it like having your hands work for Disney? Mickey Mouse gloves over here. I loved you in Cool World.
Mike, were those copper? Were those copper gloves? There's like world. There's like.
Oh my god, bro! What the hell?
Were you wearing those therapeutic gloves? You know,
like when someone wears fingerless gloves on because my hands get cold at the register.
I knew it.
Wow!
I knew it was because there was a register gloves. I knew it.
Oh yeah, dude. My bodega
there
gloves.
There was a Cool World drop.
It's the Cool World drop, dude. Sure
I wasn't cool. ready for that today.
Holy shit!
I wasn't expecting that. Oh my god!
Dan's hands, huh?
Boy, I'm going to go.
Dan Mitz Miller, yeah. You got hands like Marv from Sin City. You have Marv hands in my mitts.
Oh, boy, I'm glad I'm laughing so hard because I'd be crying if I wasn't.
How do you describe Dan's hands, Frank Miller? Okay.
I've been hearing this my whole life.
Dan's hands has eyebrows.
Where do you shake my dad's hands?
Jesus.
They're the worst. It's the worst.
Oh, no.
Believe it or not, my dad's hands are bigger than mine. It's crazy.
Wow.
What? Yeah, I don't get it. I don't understand what happened there. If only I could be as tall as my hands are big, I'd be massive, dude.
You'd be massive, bro. You'd be like a power lifter's head. Like it's nuts. You're like the anti Popeye. It just goes here instead of your forearm. It stopped here.
Oh God.
Whew. Same for me. Public and shame. That's what we call them as well.
Jesus. Butterfingers, literally.
Like the candy bar?
Yeah.
Nice. I thought he meant like the Packers receiving corps.
Oh! Another Bortz reference.
Thank you, Boop. I think Boop is correct here.
What did Boop say?
Well, obviously.
I'm the one making fun of Dan's hands here.
I know, I'm not doing anything.
You're laughing.
Well, yeah, I'm laughing. Everybody else is.
You're doing that. Trying very hard to sit like a small person. Right
you're doing that cackle. You even went like an old prospector in the middle of that cackle. Yeah, gold.
Hey, good gold, I tell you.
Yeah. Oh boy.
So yeah, Boba Fett.
He had one tooth.
Oh, yeah, Boba Fett, guys.
So, yeah, Boba Fett, guys.
Yes. So, Boba Fett.
Okay, wait. We haven't talked about that last scene with the music. The Mandalorian theme.
Right. When he's talking about, Fennec's talking about how we can hire some people.
Yeah. Credits by muscle.
Now, do you think it's going to be the Mando? What? Do you think it's going to be the Mando, or do you think it's going to be the covert?
I mean, it's the Mando. It's Din Djarin's theme song, so I'd say it's Din Djarin.
Right. I agree too. When I heard that music, I was like, Ludwig, you son of a bitch. You crafty man.
Who else?
Well, I mean, there's a Fennec was she's alluding to like there's plenty of muscle out there that you could hire. So I feel like it's going to be more than Din Djarin, but I feel like he's going to be like maybe the Top Gun, but I feel like there's going to be other mercenaries and bounty hunters. Like we could see more comic book characters come in, like Valance. That'd be dope.
Or maybe Bosk.
Yeah.
Or how about this? How about somebody that we've already seen? Maybe a little Space Boston, Miggs Mayfield.
Space Boston.
I'm so there for the Space Boston. I'm there for the Space Boston.
I'm down for Miggs.
He's a mercenary.
Yeah, he is.
I mean, he's got an action figure. You know, he's going to be back in some capacity. You know.
Yeah, he's Bill Burr, that Mando music could have meant anything. It could have meant anybody that we've seen in The Mandalorian. You know, I mean, your instant thought is to think Din, which is definitely the right, you know, thought to think.
It's
but
right not to think.
right thought. Really?
It is the right.
You did
thought
it.
To think, Din. Well done.
That's me.
Right thought. To think. Right you, thought.
Good thinking, no stops.
But seriously, I just, you know, that's what your brain immediately wants to go for hearing that music. But like thinking about it a little more, thinking more thoughts. Mm-hmm. Yes, it could be anybody from the Mando. It could have been any of those hired guns you've seen from the Mando. You know, it's totally could possible. Be? Even freaking Toro. Ugh.
He's dead.
Oh, yeah, that's right. He is dead. That's right. Dead. I'm bad at remembering people that were alive. Yeah, I do this with Marvel too. What if he got modded?
And it just disappeared.
That's right.
Oh my god.
But no, seriously, we could definitely see that there could be more people. But I'm thinking it would be great if it was just like the Mandos entirely, like the covert, you know.
That'd be pretty cool.
His other family.
Pretty much rejected. All of them dead too.
I mean, we never saw the armor die.
No, not the armor, definitely.
And we didn't see the heavy gunner that John Favreau did the voice for.
Yeah, right? We didn't see any of them.
No, we just saw all the armor left over. So, you know.
Yeah. I mean, and what about IG-11? I mean, maybe like IG-88, he's got his consciousness downloaded and backed up somewhere else.
Yeah.
Dan, that is a wild theory, and I love it.
I know it's wild.
It's wild.
We don't do the same thing over twice. I mean, IG-11. Stop it.
Chris is shaking his head down. He's saying no.
We can see a particular Duro's bounty.
He's saying no because Chris is like the almighty Star Wars.
We can see Chris in the control room.
What is Chris saying no to, though?
I don't know.
I thought it was my IG-11 idea.
Chris, explain why you're saying no.
Your no.
We need
IG-11. That's just it's one and done. He was reprogrammed. It's that single thing.
No, I think what he's saying is the IG-88, because that consciousness is uploaded to the actual manufacturer. You know what I mean? It's a bounty hunter droid. There's more than one.
Now, Chris said
that particular one was reprogrammed and all that.
Oh, so no, yeah. IG-11, yeah, definitely is not. He's done. IG-88, though, he's out there.
You never know.
Chris just actually do. Wait, do the glasses. Do the glasses, Roke.
Listen, guys. He crushed us all in Star Wars Jeopardy. I'm not gonna question.
It was wild.
Not gonna question. I just like to think outside the box sometimes.
He was like,
it would be cool to see IG-11 come back with Taika Waititi.
But if that happened, then people would complain that, you know, characters have to die and you can't bring them back over and over again. And then if you don't do it, you'll have people complain that you haven't.
Yeah, people complain anyway, Raven. Complain anyway. They complain about everything.
I just wanted to preemptively point out how fucking stupid they were.
People complain about the number of rear view mirrors on the space scooters.
And how shiny they
zippers.
Were.
Zippers, dude.
Claire's here. Oh, hit the button.
Claire. When are
you look hungry.
Oh my god. Hello everyone. Wow, my AirPods.
Have a drum stick.
Worst ever.
Yay!
I had to pop in for a minute real quick.
This just in.
I have a very patient significant other who sat through 16 Braves playoff games and 2 Georgia football playoff games, who is from the state of Missouri. So I apologize for being so late. I know we're in overtime right now, but I needed to come in and say, I'm so happy for you, Dan, this episode, even if you are a hateful bastard.
Right.
Claire.
I got my vindication.
This talk about this thing. Wait till you see this fool talk about what happened.
I am selfish. I am wrong.
I mean... You are. Yeah,
right.
Well, we already knew that. Like, come on now.
Mark the tape.
Hey, Claire, did you know that Dan has massive hands?
Massive hands. Wow. Yeah. I'm learning new things.
I shook Dan's hand the other day, and I was like, fuck.
Yeah. Do you ever see Who Framed Roger Rabbit?
I did.
All right. That is enough, Jackson.
What? Don't get upset because Dan's hands are welding gloves.
Where did the guy was going to go with that, Raven?
I have a very bad idea, and I don't want to be right. Oh, no.
Well, all right, let's let Claire get her thought off. Let's let Claire get the thought off real quick.
Oh. Well, now she can't think of anything but your hands, Dan.
Shut up, Dan, damn it.
Oh, yeah, by the way, Tommy, Dan's hands are massive.
Oh. But, yeah. That explains when he slaps something, it sounds like a brick hitting a wall.
Yeah. You're so excited, Sarah, we have called the cops.
I really am so excited to see you again. And the first thing I'm going to do is do the high five and then immediately grab your wrist and be like, what the fuck is wrong with
you? Yeah, but it's only going to be my index finger and you're going to think it's my wrist.
Yeah. You just have to watch out for the wave of air that he pushes at you, though.
Amazing. Amazing.
You got to keep these things refrigerated, man.
Holy shit. I can't do this right now.
Gracious.
There are so many things I'm not saying right now.
Thank you for being on the same wavelength.
This reminds me in Shallow Hal when he shakes Tim Robbins' hand in the elevator.
He's like, watch it, banana hands.
Can you hold your hand up, Dan? Can you hold your hand up, please?
Stay
put. Look at you, Miss Marvel.
What the hell?
Look at that.
Those are some holy working hands crap. Right there.
Wait, where was that right next to your head? I thought you put it right in front of the camera. Holy
shit. Hey, Dan, did you know that if one time, never saw it again. Is as big as your face, you have cancer?
No, I'm not falling for that shit.
Yeah. Dan threw a football one time, never saw it again. Orbit.
Got him. Almost.
He killed somebody.
You can roof a napkin. You're so strong.
You can roof a napkin.
Jesus.
Heads are massive.
Oh, goodness.
I'm not sure if these are compliments or insults.
He just changes tires. Like, it just changes them.
All right, damn it. Can we just let Claire
puts it on.
Get her thought off?
Put the goddamn hands away first, Dan.
Oh my god.
Is he arms or his hands?
Hands. Y'all are crazy.
He's like Rayman. Just float.
Do go on, Claire.
Gracious me.
Oh, God.
Just say what you wanted to say.
Oh, God. Anyway, weird Star Wars is the best Star Wars. Droids are the best. This is a top-notch droids episode.
Yes.
Top-notch weirdos yes. episode. Boba Fett used mm-hmm. the phrase, go make Bantha babies.
Yes.
And good God, so much happened in this episode. We went to a Star Wars tattoo robotics parlor and listened to space techno. And I'm just living. I'm just living for the strange. Nope. So yeah. Keep being weird, Boba Fett. Keep being weird, amen. Sweet little marshmallow amen. Man. I'm here for it.
Speaking of droids, I love the General Grievous droid where he was just like, like all General the knives, dude. All the yeah, General Cleavis. Yeah.
Oh I'm pretty God. Sure those are all like appliances because I'm pretty yeah. sure that main one was a KitchenAid mixer. Yeah, KitchenAid yeah. mixer as a head.
As a head, yeah.
I was like, that's a KitchenAid mixer. That's a lot of money.
Was he? Do you think that was the same droid from Return of the Jedi?
Why not?
You mean like the torture guy or
probably?
Well, he was the one that was like talking shit to R2. Remember?
Well, if that's the case,
hey Ethan, what's up?
KitchenAid.
Yeah!
Woo! Good. Good.
Good.
Wow, I literally just came down here to say hi and be like, hi, this man has sat through 18 playoff games for my two teams, and I just missed the end of the first one.
Star Wars. But they're playing again, though.
They're playing again. I mean, they're playing again. Let's go. Chiefs Nation, is that what I'm supposed to say? What is the phrase? I don't know. Whatever it is. Whatever it is. Bandwagon, because you are a Braves and Georgia fan for the year. So. Yeah.
Hey, Andy Reid is awesome. As a Philadelphia Eagles fan, I love Reid. I love him.
Man, put your phone figure away. Oh, never mind.
He absolutely deserves
we're number one.
Phone figure. Your foam right. finger.
Oh,
the joke is Dan has massive hands. They're that's massive. What today.
Okay.
Yeah. Don't be uncomfortable with his massive hands. You should see him in
the jack-o'-lantern. It's crazy. Just, ah!
All right.
How it is causing a group meltdown not unlike the one where we found out how tall Jackson is. This is the part that concerns me.
Yeah.
Jackson's like 9 feet tall.
He's like ducks under doors.
But his camera persists that he's five. I'm not going to get into it. But he's 5'7".
My camera is suspended on the ceiling.
I was lied to.
You be quiet, Roke.
You were misled by false advertising. Lied to.
Raven is supposed to be 6'3". This is bullshit.
I know that is true. That is true.
Correct. Ethan, I am super happy for you that the Chiefs won. Yeah. Hopefully another Super Bowl.
Yes, I am ready for it.
I can't wait for the halftime, though.
Yeah, Ethan.
Be rude, Dan.
It can't be.
Come on, Ethan. Give it a try. Give it a try.
With him. Fuck this. No, don't.
He's
don't.
Like, I'm being
listen
nice
to the mob, man. If everybody told you to jump off a bridge, would you do it?
Yeah.
Maybe.
I would. I'd jump off a bridge if a guy with giant hands was chasing me.
Exactly. Yo, I love you.
All right.
I was getting nervous. He was pointing around and things. I was like,
all right, guys, look at we are reaching the hour mark.
The locomotive is barreling through the trees, and it's all over.
Has it been an hour? Ring.
Dan, the Swatter Miller.
We are reaching an hour. We are reaching the hour mark, and I would like everybody to.
Hey, Voltron, form.
Chris.
All hands on deck.
A prediction.
What do you think
we're gonna see in episode 5? What do you think is going Jim, just tell fault. Us what you want to see happen or what you think is gonna happen. Roke, you go.
Mando. We're gonna see Mando.
Okay. Jackson.
Yeah, I mean it's gonna be Mando. Oh yeah. I mean
Raven?
I think it's going to be Mando too.
Man, this is a 3 out of 3 so far. Christopher?
I mean, it's got to be, right?
It's going to be a Grief Karga.
Yes! Oh! Carl Weathers, everybody. That's what I'm about.
And Mando.
And that's it.
Claire and Egan, what do you guys think? What do you guys want to see or think you're going to see episode 5?
I think I'm going to see Mando. I would also like to see that sexy corn on the cob vamp. I would be very pleased.
Corn on the All cob. Right. All right. Old cob vamp. Ethan, what do you think?
I mean, come on. It's got to be Mando. Come on.
All right.
I mean,
all
right.
It must.
Jerry, Mando's all around one grief. Okay. Tommy?
Obviously, Mando. Revan. We're all in consensus with that one. But I feel like we're also going to see, I mean, they're already trying to introduce comic book characters and book characters. So I feel like we're going to see one of those, like either Valance or maybe Dash Rendar, or I don't know.
Jackson.
Ooh, he said Dash Rendar.
The
Dash
only reason.
Rendar.
Chris can't handle the legends. He can't handle it, Tommy. You can't mention your legend stuff
the
to Chris.
The only reason I laugh so hard at Dash Rendar is knowing that Charlie Merson Wright Ashby, my Imperial Senate co-host, his blood pressure would go through the roof because he absolutely hates Dash Rendar more than like most things on this planet that have ever been. He hates him.
He's a wall. He's a Walmart Han Solo.
Yeah, and it makes me like we always joke like around Han about Solo.
Yeah, wish that. Yeah.
He can't even take a joke. He can't even jokingly be like, "Hey, Charlie, I bet Dash Rendar is going to show up." He's just like, "No."
Well, you know who's going to get a lot of Dash Rendar merchandise for Christmas this year.
That's right.
That's right. Oh my god. Now that we know that, dude, I am gonna blow his Twitter. Oh my god. No. It's gonna be great. Claire, thank you. Thank you, Claire. Thank you. Anyway, I'm also thinking that it's like the second I heard that music, I'm thinking Mando. But then talking to all y'all, it could be many possibilities from The Mandalorian. And I'm loving some Greef Karga, Chris. I love that.
That's a good one.
I mean, not like him by himself, like him with like a cadre.
But like bringing the guild. Yes, dude, I'm loving that idea.
That's what I'm saying.
That's what I'm saying.
I feel a hologram and message coming up and talking to Din on the hologram and then being a connection to someone else.
Or Boba getting,
that's just what I kind of felt from it. Like, right. I bet he reaches out to get a connection that way so you'll see Din, but not actually...
How about a little comms officer? Katie O'Brien, comms officer, baby.
What about what was the name of Din's cult? Right. His Mando cult.
The covert.
Children
of the Watch, yeah.
So children
the covert
of the
is where they stay.
What if Mando and the Watch show up?
Ooh. Yeah, that's what I'm
also give me some armorer because she cute.
Yes, I said that
bring
earlier.
Armor.
I was like, we never
Mando
and the Watch.
I love that song.
Mando,
obviously.
Mando and the Watch.
We've got 3 episodes left. Somebody's had too much space hops. We've got 3 episodes left, and they're going to be all bangers, I think. We're going to get some banger last 3 episodes. I think it's all going to happen. We're definitely going to see something from The Mandalorian happen because they are starting to tie it in with this episode right here. We saw Mando tie-ins. It's happening. Guys, thank you all for joining us. Claire, Ethan, thanks for popping in for the last bit. Tommy, thanks for jumping in on your break. Everybody, thanks for being here. Everybody in the chat, thanks for making fun of my hands with everyone.
actual size dance hands.
Oh my god.
We all love you. Put that dramatization away.
We all love you. I love you. We can't wait to see you next week.
We love you too. Yeah.
I'm just kidding. I'm not kidding about loving everybody. I love everyone.
Hey, Rope, when Dan does this, he knocks people over.
We'll see you guys next week at 9. Make sure to check out the book.
Oh my god, Cold Fusion.
Make sure to check out the Book of Broba. Book of Broba dropping Tuesday at 3. Is it 3, Chris? Is it 3 or 2? Is it 3?
Sure.
It's 3 o'clock on Tuesdays. And if you want to be a Patreon and get it earlier, it'll be dropping on Monday.
You know you do.
We've got ourselves now. on the podcast realm, so you can listen to audio on your way to work through Spotify and other podcast apps. Check us out.
A lot of mercy.
I'm talking about Raven. You know what I'm talking about?
We will see you all next week. And this is the way.
This party's over.
Over. Over. Over. Over.
It's not over yet.
Fire coming in, point three.
This is it. This is it.
Look at the size.